Anytime I have out-of-town guests, I always take them to Ybor City. It's one of Tampa's coolest, hippest, most historic, unique districts, and I love it, and it's always a big hit. But what would it be like to live there? Hey everyone, my name is Amy. Welcome to my Tampa Area Living channel. Ybor City, the historic district, is located about 2 miles from right downtown Tampa. And even though it's very small, it's right next to and part of the big city. It's a world-renowned tourist destination because of its architecture, its art and culture, its food scene, its nightlife, and chickens. It's an amazing place to visit. Let's talk about some of the perks that you would have living in Ybor City. Ybor City offers all the good things that a typical urban setting offer. Easy access to downtown, your commute. You could bike to work in downtown or take a scooter, the trolley, the bus. For that, for transportation, you'd never have to get on I-4, which would be awesome. I'd say that Ybor City is ideal for anybody who loves a trendy, hip, happening kind of urban setting. The downside to living in Ybor City might be exactly what the perks are. If you prefer the suburbs, I hesitate to say a quiet life because I just spent the evening in Ybor City last night. It was so peaceful and so quiet. But again, city living is not for everyone. If you prefer to stay away from the hustle and bustle of the city, which obviously sometimes it can be very crowded at night, there's a very vibrant nightlife scene in Ybor City, then if you don't want to live in the middle of that, then this is not the place for you. Let's talk about housing options in Ybor City. The easiest housing to acquire in Ybor City is going to be an apartment. Most residents of Ybor City rent rather than own their homes, and the options for rentals range from individually owned houses or condos to larger complexes with lots of amenities. Rent prices start at around $1,000 a month for smaller apartments with few or no amenities, or $1,400 or $1,500 a month or more for studio apartments of around 500 square feet with lots of amenities, to larger apartments of 3 or 4 bedrooms for as much as $3,000 or more per month. At the time of this video, there were smaller loft apartments available in the historic district, but there are many apartments for rent in nearby communities. If you want to own a home in Ybor, the most plentiful option, in fact, the only option available right now, are condos. But so many of them are kind of this highly desirable condo like this one. It has 2 bedrooms, 2 baths, it's around 1,600 square feet, and it's listed for $409. Now for single family homes, as I talked about, we'd have to go a block or two north. And in fact, there are new homes being built there right now. For single family homes, you'd have to travel outside the historic district, at least right now, because there were none currently available. But just a few blocks away from the historic district, there's an area where a lot of construction and renovation is happening. Many of the older homes are being torn down to make way for new homes, and some are being completely renovated. There's a huge range of home prices in these areas north of the historic district. For example, you can still buy a home for around or even slightly less than $100,000, but you should be aware that for many of these, a buyer would have to bring cash. There are still some older homes available ranging anywhere from $180,000 to $350,000, and for the newer or completely renovated homes, they range from around $375,000 to over $400,000.
Personally, I think that living in Ybor would be an awesome option. I love the idea of being plugged into a super supportive local business community, not only a supportive business community, but a creative business community. And I can easily see the appeal of living there. I have something for you in the description box. It's a relocation guide and home buying guide specifically for this area. Of course, it's free. Please take it. And don't hesitate to ask questions. Also, you know that the market is tight, so if you're interested in having the latest listings emailed to you, there's also a link for that. Thanks so much for watching. I hope to see you next time.